Live from San Francisco, California, I'm Adrian Mans. I'm here with John Buckingham. He's the editor of The Prudent Speculator. Let's get his views on the markets. Market hit some highs. Market flattened out. Market went soaring lower. Where do you think we're going?
Well, we're going to go up, we're going to go down. That's generally par for the course. People need to understand that volatility is normal.
Right.
Even though we had an 800-point drop on the Dow, that was quote-unquote only 3.06%. And believe it or not, it's been about 284 times previously we've had declines of that magnitude. It's just a big number, so that can cause consternation. But volatility is normal. I think it's actually healthy to squeeze out any excesses that might have been out there and kind of reset things as we head into the rest of the year and into 2020. But in my mind, valuations are really attractive, especially given the drop we've seen in interest rates. When you're talking about a 10-year treasury yielding 1.5, 1.6, and heck, a 30-year treasury yielding 2%, dividend yields on the S&P 500 are in the 2% range. Dividend yields on value-oriented stocks like we favor at the Prudent Speculator, those stocks, we have yields of 3%. So income from equities is really attractive in this current environment.
So I think, you know, in talking to traders and talking to the guys we work with, the pessimism comes from the fact that the moves in the market are so fast now, right? Where we used to get big, you know, I remember even 2008, you could play the moves on the big corrections. Today, we wind up sitting out a couple days after a big move, right? Because we know there's going to be so much excess volatility. Where do you advise people to go sort of longer term on the defensive posture on these things, right? So you don't get hit as hard when things get big.
Right. Well, to be candid, we don't time the market.
Yeah.
So we've participated in every single downturn that has happened, but yet we have a fantastic long-term track record. Very few people can time the market effectively.
Right.
More power to those who can, but what we believe is that if you buy good companies, you buy them on sale with generous dividend yields, and you hold them through thick and thin, you're likely to be far better off. Now, you have to have a strong stomach. We certainly understand that.
Right.
And not everybody can have 100% of their investments in equities. But the way you mitigate that is by asset allocation, by not having all of your eggs, if you will, in the stock market basket. But in our mind, we think that valuations are so attractive. We sleep very well at night when the average PE on our portfolio is around 12, when the average dividend yield is 3%. So yes, markets will fluctuate. They always have. They always will. Volatility we're seeing is normal. It's nothing unusual. And heck, we've had 35% pullback since the end of 2009, the market bottom.
Right.
So, you know, we can't get too, you know, concerned about the most recent decline.
Any particular stocks or sectors you're focusing on right now or that you think are attractive?
Well, we generally speaking like to buy the stuff that gets beaten up, that's on sale. So here lately with the threat of tariffs, consumer discretionary area has gotten hit really hard.
Right.
Some of the retail stocks have been crushed. So names like Kohl's, which we think is the big department store operator, KSS, the ticker symbol. Generous dividend yield, still earnings that we think will be healthy. Of course, they have a partnership with Amazon, so we don't think they're going to be Amazon. So we think that stocks like that, single-digit PE, again, a big yield, that would be a name we'd like. And then if you also think in consumer discretionary, the cruise operator, something like a Royal Caribbean, has been hit hard here in the pullback. And frankly, we think the demographic trends for cruising are very favorable in the long run. So I think people could take advantage of some excesses that we've seen in this downturn, as opposed to, say, heading into safer or defensive stocks. We'd rather, as a long-term investor, take advantage of the masses that have stampeded out of those stocks. And frankly, if we owned utilities, which we don't, we might actually want to take some money off the table as a result of the rally that we've seen.
Gotcha. What about some of the consumer staples as well? You think they're going to stay firm where they are? People always need soap. And
well, yeah, that's, you know, the masses have crowded into those stocks.
Right.
And we own things like Walmart, which, you know, technically it's not a consumer staple, I suppose, even though it is in that category.
Yeah.
But so there are, we do have exposure there. But we had owned a stock, Kimberly-Clark, in the past as a defensive stock when it went on sale. Big dividend yield, reasonable valuation. That's a name we sold here recently as it had held up extraordinarily well in the market volatility. So I think that those are richly valued, and I'd be focused as a long-term investor.
Mm-hmm.
Again, not as a you know, as someone trying to, you know, be very careful about the short term. As a long-term investor, this is a time you want to take advantage of what the market's giving you.
Okay, and if people want to follow your thoughts on the markets, where can they get hold of you?
Well, we publish the Prudent Speculator newsletter, so theprudentspeculator.com, where we operate out of Aliso Viejo, California. We manage money, and we publish the investment newsletter.
Okay, and email address for you if someone wants to contact you?
It's jbuckingham@kovitz.com.
Okay, thank you. We'll be back in a moment with more. I'm Adrian Manns for The Money Show.